What's up, you asa? So for this week's project, I'm gonna be doing a skull with some roses and a little bit of color. When it comes down to doing your stencil, just make sure that you can read it. In my case, I like my stencil super simple. For this project, I'm gonna split it into 2 days because it has a whole bunch of detail. Okay, let's get this day started. When I print out my stencil, I like to blow it up as big as I can, so I ended up dividing it into 4 papers. Now that's extremely big, but it might fit. Damn, that looks huge. Oh, look at this. It looks perfect. For this project, I'm gonna be using a 14 round shader and a 15 curve mag. These are the colors that I'm gonna be using today. But first, let me show you some heel tattoos. It's been over a year since I did these 2 tattoos and I am satisfied on how they healed up. Anyways, let's get started. If you watch my previous videos, you know that my 14 round shader is my favorite needle to use.
You want me to turn it up?
After applying my first layer of black, now I'm ready to start applying my gray tones. There are 2 things that might happen while using true grays. One is that your stencil might wipe away a lot faster, or 2, it might become so difficult to blend in the grays from dark to light. It is a bit difficult to explain on how I apply my gray tones because not everyone has the same hand speed or the same voltage. But what I can tell you is, start applying a little bit of gray tones into your background to start practicing. One thing that I do is that I always apply my black ink first, and that will tell me how dark or how light I have to apply my grays. Time for some color. So I'm gonna start by outlining the whole rose. That way I can feel comfortable when I'm packing in my colors. It's time to help out my client and numb his skin so I can apply these white highlights. The needle that I'm using is a 9 flat mag and an 8 round liner. And that concludes our first day. It was a total success. So good night, and I'll see you tomorrow.
Vengo de un pueblo, es algo inexplicable, pero te prometo que yo soy incomparable. Yo soy un infante y eso es muy impactante. Soy un niño pobre brillando como diamante.
Let's get this second day started. Now, I have nothing else to say, so I'm just gonna let you guys watch this video, and I hope you guys found this tutorial very useful.
Yeah, yo, rapping off the tip top, yeah. Killing time, no wristwatch, they're never gonna block me in. Nope. You need a big box, no hezzy, I'm taking my shot like vodka on the rocks. I'm working on a record while you're swiping on your TikTok, you like that. They gon' throw the shade and I'ma fight back, yep. Spray him with gasoline and ignite that. Turn him into coal like Jay, get it, my right hand is falling asleep, cause I've been writing on my nightstand. Whoa, too many people sleeping on me, better change the sheets. I got too many ends, but I'm for sure I'll make them meet. Yep. And I ain't strapped, but lyrically I'm packing heavy heat. Like every single bar that I spit is burning feet for a week.
We all something. Alright, so we finally completed this project. We ended up doing a skull with some colored roses, and I ended up splitting it in two different days. There was too much detail, so I know I couldn't finish it in one day. I'm glad we did it in 2 days because I was able to kind of just chill and navigate. We were having fun. How was your experience?
Now, I enjoyed the session as well too. Doing it in 2 days definitely helped out. That way I wasn't taking that much of a beating.
That elbow though, yeah. That freaking elbow messed you up.
That was gnarly.
I think that's, is it swollen right now? Nah, it's not swollen.
Nah, not too bad.
Yeah, so it was a dope ass piece, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I see you guys next week. All right.